It's 1992, and what was being described as the most important game in a generation for Manchester United. They still had a chance of winning the league, but rivals Leeds had won earlier in the day, so the title was in danger of slipping away.
Manchester United really had this Barclays Championship by the throat, but their grip is now severely loosened by that stumbling run over the last week and the success of Leeds United today. Last three games for Manchester United with 9 points at stake. They've picked up just a solitary point. And there you have it all, really. A long kick by Schmeichel. A good jump by Wright. In goes Kanchelskis down his right flank. Away by Mulvey. Up to Rush. Watson is heavily involved early on. Pallister slipping, getting the ball to Ince. Frenetic opening, but then you expect that when Liverpool and Manchester United get together on a football pitch anywhere. Wright gets it back.
I think the referee has got to be on his toes in the early exchanges here, Brian, because as you know, there's no love lost between the two clubs, and with so much depending on today's game, the early exchanges are going to be really ferocious.
Pallister guiding the ball behind for the goal kick. Now we wonder, will Manchester United react to that Leeds United victory earlier this afternoon? Some say they might be deflated, but I suppose if there's anything about them, it really will get them to stick their chins and their chests out and really go for it today. Certainly, I have to say, when they came off their team coach and walked down the corridor to the dressing room, they did look a little on the deflated side. One or two of them, who are usually the most cheerful of souls, really could hardly raise a smile. Kanchelskis, Donaghy, certainly one of those who's not fit. Now Donaghy, Kanchelskis. So Donaghy, a free kick for Manchester United. An afternoon, really, that Watson gets it back, that's carried along by its importance and its emotion. And just as well, really, because the form of both sides has deserted them. Just as United have had their rocky spell, so have Liverpool. No wins for Liverpool, except, of course, that penalty shootout against Portsmouth. No wins in seven games. And Liverpool just with one goal in their last five, but say when these two sides meet, you never quite know. Tanner in very positively above Mark Hughes. Knocked away there by Thomas. Donaghy turning away from the possibility of a back pass with Saunders between him and the goalkeeper. Kanchelskis. One of those games where the opening goal will mean so much. If it goes United's way, it surely will lift them. And it'll give them a real sinking feeling if it is planted beyond Peter Schmeichel. Rush going away, just fractionally offside, not much in it.
I think the wind's going to be a factor today, Brian, because it really is blustery here at Anfield. Liverpool like to knock the ball around, they like to keep it on the floor, but I think today's going to be difficult for either team to play a bit of football here.
Here's Pallister with a free kick for Manchester in this blue strip of theirs, up towards Hughes. Tanner really wrestling all over him there. Kanchelskis heading again for Giggs. Back for Kanchelskis. A clears on the far side, a little too high for him. Irwin might seek to turn it back. It's a goal kick.
I see Graham McClears sort of withdrawn into midfield there to supplement Ensign Robson in there. Leaving Mark Hughes up to battle away against Mark Wright.
Robson's header, Hughes, McClair, the flag is up.
I tell you what will be interesting today, Brian. in the last two or three games, the ones that we've watched on television with Liverpool, they've been pushing up, playing offside. Now, it's something that I've never seen in all the years of watching Liverpool and having played here. They never, ever played offside. They just held the ground. But now they seem to be pushing up, and I think we're an example there, and they may get caught this afternoon.
McClare. Well, people with the pace of Kanchelskis and Giggs are just the sort of people with well-timed runs who might catch them out. And incidentally, it looks as though Kanchelskis and Giggs are pushing well forward themselves here this afternoon.
Well, but Manchester will be hoping that the two wingers can do some damage down the flanks, but they're against two quick throwbacks.
Indeed. David Burrows is back after a little spill out with injury, and Rob Jones at right back. For Liverpool. Donaghy with the throw for Manchester United. Robson. Done by Hughes. Giggs trying to get in there. Mike Hooper safely catching the ball. Bruce Grobbelaar still out, of course, with his hamstring. And you'll get no clue from Bruce as to when he's going to be back again, whether he'll be back for the cup final in a fortnight's time. Say he'd be playing in one cup final. Apparently he's in the final of his winter foursomes at his golf club. Grobbelaar. It's a throw to Manchester United. Easter for Manchester United with the defeats against Nottingham Forest, Old Trafford, and then the midweek defeats down at Upton Park against West Ham. Really seen for so long to have it all sewn up, but here's Kanchelskis. It'll be Donaghy again with the throw. Get up! Tanner's header away for Liverpool. And that came off Donaghy, Liverpool's throw. He's got Giggs waiting on the far touchline. Down to Giggs again. Good ball played by Irwin. Giggs really taking on right here. And he gets a corner out of the Liverpool captain. Kanchelskis, number five. Bruce on the edge of the penalty area. At the near post, and he needed the header of Molby to get it away for Liverpool. Certainly surprised to see Paul Ince back in the side. Certainly the feeling was that his season might well be over, but Alex Ferguson told me that both he and Robson asked to play. Said they weren't fully fit, but felt they really wanted to get in and join this battle.
You know, Brian Robson really has been the key figure this year for Manchester United. Al said at the beginning of the season, if he stays fit, plays through the season, they'll win the league. And I think they've certainly missed him when he's been out.
There's no doubt about that. McClare, Hughes. In fact, I think it's five, not six games, five games that Robson's been out since.
and they've got 5 points out of a possible 15.
It just happened at the crucial time of the year for them, you know, what a pity.
Here's Ray Houghton. Had a really good season for Liverpool. Mulvey. Slipped by Saunders. Robson getting it away. Goes Hughes, beats Tanner, finds Kanchelskis. Good run here by Kanchelskis. In the end, couldn't find the pass for Hughes, couldn't find the shot for himself. And it's 0-0 with 10 minutes gone.
Well done, Jan Molby there. Kanchelskis had ripped the Liverpool defence apart there. He's looking really on song down this right-hand side. As is Giggs, of course, as well down the left. And that's a great confrontation, isn't it? The two young outstanding players this year, Rob Jones and Ryan Giggs.
Rob Jones, Saint, as you probably remember, who made his first appearance for Liverpool when he joined them from Crewe in the midweek at Old Trafford against Manchester United. That's an absolutely superb game. Robson. Mark Wright. Wright again. Steve Nicholas sent me, so Ronnie Moran was telling me, has got a little knock and they just don't want to risk him. I suppose with a cup final coming up in a fortnight's time, that's quite understandable. Kanchelskis, in goes Burrows very quickly indeed. But equally quick was Donaghy, halting Saunders in his tracks. Thomas, to Jan Molby, to John Barnes, a little pick of a good one, to Rush, has scored! Liverpool in the lead, and that truly is a moment for this championship of the Barclays League to take another twist and another turn as Liverpool go ahead. Rush just getting to the ball before Schmeichel.
Well, he's finally done it, Brian. He's finally got the goal. What a lovely ball by John Barnes. And Rush made a great diagonal run, nicked it over the keeper in the corner.
Never scored against Manchester United in all his career. Some 24 attempts, and at last, Rush has done it. Now, what reaction will this get from Manchester United? Only his eighth goal of the season, and you can't believe it, really. Such a prolific scorer, only his fourth in the Barclays League.
My first reaction, Brian, about the goal was that he may have sprayed offside when he made the burst, but I'm not sure maybe if Bruce was playing him onside.
Maybe we might get another chance to look at that a little later on when there's a lull. That's it. A long clearance by Schmeichel. Kick to Liverpool. A long clearance by Mark Wright and a goal kick for Manchester United. So that was like the old Rush as well, wasn't it? I mean, he was so quickly onto that.
Exactly.
Leclerc, Ince. People so ready to say that Rush isn't quite what he was. You just better not believe it.
His goal tally, of course, is very poor this year, Brian, for the English. Normally gets a 1-2 ratio, but at the moment it's very poor. But he's had injuries, so he could probably say that that's been the reason for it. But that was the old Ian Rush, wasn't it? Sharpest attack.
Here we are again. Now, as Barnes plays,
he's not onside. Dennis Irwin's playing him onside as well. A
was a beautifully judged run.
Here's Barnes. Rush. That's a foul for sure. That's a free kick for Liverpool. There's Rush trying to shove McClure off the ball. McClure holding up the taking of that free kick. And certainly want to bring the substitute on. And indeed, you're right, Saint. It's Nicky Tanner. So Venison's on. Let's see who joins Mark Wright as centre-back now. David Burrows at the moment looks to be...
Looks as if David Burrows has just moved in there and Venison played fullback. He's played centre-back a bit this year, hasn't he, Burrows?
Indeed.
On and off with all the injuries.
Good challenge again by Rush. And some quick thinking by Saul as he saw Schmeichel off his line, aimed instantly... chip, but it's in fact can go for United defender. But Liverpool looking the sharper of the two sides of the
Well, United started off, I thought, Brian, in the first 10 minutes, looking really aggressive, and the team that were doing all the pressing, but since the goal, of course, Liverpool seemed to have settled down a bit and commanding the game there.
Oh, but there's Watson, that changes everything. It's with the shots! Oh, bad luck there for United. It cannoned off the post with Hooper well and truly beaten. United's last month of the season in an instant. A good raking shot, sorry, Saint, by Paul Ince.
It was the most magnificent effort, wasn't it? Totally deserved a goal, but when that happens, Brian, I think it's time to go home, isn't it?
Started by a great tackle by Brian Robson as well. It's a free kick to Manchester United.
Giggs with it, flipped off the defender towards Bruce on the far side, turned back well by him towards Mark Hughes. It was Jones who got it away, and then Donaghy putting it behind for the goal kick.
That was the Robson part in it, a really good, fierce, well-timed challenge there. Ince with the shot, Hooper's despairing dive. 99 times out of 100 that would have gone flipped it.
I mean, it was really spectacular, wasn't it? Kept it low, really thumped it, and there you are.
But in a nutshell, that's United over the last month.
Well, that's the way it's been going for them, Brian.
Alistair. McClure touched on. Hughes. Burrows. Here's Jan Molby to Dean Saunders. Michael Thomas away on the right for him. Rush is going through the middle. Barnes is coming in there as well, but Thomas had the glint of glory in his eyes and wanted to finish it off himself. Now Ryan Giggs. Owen. Here's Houghton, little chip, perfect one as well for Saunders, played on by Molby, then for Rush. Jones, for Saunders. And Ince playing the ball for Irwin. Room ahead of him, Giggs ahead of him. Hooper is out quickly, massive clearance.
The game's been played at a ferocious pace, and looking at Liverpool today, I think this is about the best I've seen them in a while, Brian, in terms of closing the game down and working hard to get the ball back. You know, everybody's fired up, and they're all working hard.
That's a good passing, too, on an excellent pitch. Which gives me the chance to congratulate the groundsman again here, Reg Summers, who... won the award for the best pitch in the First Division. Gets his award at half-time from the Football League president, Gordon McKay. So, well done, Reg.
Nice change for Manchester United, we're playing in this.
Indeed. Saunders versus Irwin. Bolby. Bruce getting it away. Bolby again. Houghton. Oh, Houghton. Played back towards Thomas. And Barnes is in there. My goodness. And Middleton's in there. And Liverpool should have been two up. What were Manchester United playing at in defence? It was almost as though they wanted to present Liverpool with a second goal. And Barnes very nearly took it with the most cheeky of back heels. Everybody shepherding, leaving it for somebody else. Barnes back heel, Benison shot into the side netting, and it stays at 1-0. The Ian Rush goal still giving Liverpool the advantage here.
Well, Schmeichel should have come for the ball there. They wait for him to come out. He didn't. He just stood still. Barnes read it, tried the back heel, and Benison really should have hit the target with that.
In the meantime, Rush has gone off, and Mark Walters is on. That had a bit of venom about it. Thomas in the end putting it away for another throw to Manchester United. With about 4 minutes of the first half left, Liverpool leading by a goal to nil. In the most beautiful sunshine here on Merseyside. But on a day that looks as though it might be a golden day for Leeds United. Morby with a throw. Up to Saunders. Donaghy, another throw for Liverpool. Saunders picking out Jan Molby. Cut out by Bruce. Leclerc, a little touch from Mike Phelan. Now Kanchelskis. Well, time challenge again by Benison.
Benison hasn't put a foot wrong since he's come on, Brian. This lad never lets the team down, you know. He comes on as substitutes, he's the odd game here and there, but I think he's always a very steady player.
Robson. He was chasing. Barrow was stumbling. But a throw going Liverpool's way. United, McClare in the 6-yard area. Bruce up from the back. Robson's poised in there as well. It's a deeper one. It might come for Dennis Irwin. But it's a goal kick.
I think they'll miss Palace to, for the set pieces, Brian, because he's such a key figure along with Bruce. And they'll miss him now. But that was a deep one there. Everybody missed it. And Dennis Irwin there looking at him. Try and keep that left foot down, but over the top it went.
Offside against Barnes. Never a doubt about it. We're in the last minute of the first half now. Certainly a big job for Manchester United to do on the rest of this afternoon, and they must know that if they concede another goal, then they might just as well concede the championship as well. Irwin going through. Hughes to Giggs. Mark Jones. Thomas giving that away. Ince with the back heel. Mark Hughes now. Well, I thought Hughes might well have had a little dig at that one there, but he preferred the pass, and it's Liverpool
is streaming away now with Mark Walters, with Barnes on the far side. Manchester United struggling to get back. Barnes goes past the ball, plays it back for Saunders. If anything, it hit Walters on the line.
That is the most amazing thing. He ran onto the goal line and he hit for the ball. I mean, Barnes was magnificent here. Look at this. Wonderful skill. He just ghosted past him. He had to look up. He picked the man out who was Saunders. Saunders, that's his own man, who actually was in offside position anyway. But
so that's why it's a free kick to Manchester United.
But look at Barnes. He's a delight when he's on form.
He looks the business again this afternoon, doesn't he?
Yes.
Barnes, the touch to Happ. Hit towards Saunders. Bruce winning it in the air. Ince finding Robson. Barnes, the lovely touch again. Thomas, no, not enough of that to Houghton, who tried to stop Irwin going through.
Irwin now leading the charge for Manchester United. And lost his way with McLaren Hughes waiting for the middle pass inside.
And he had Giggs wide on the left, they're on his own, but he could have played out there. Got Giggs in.
Half-time whistle. 45 minutes in which Liverpool have got a goal up. After 11 minutes, Ian Rush, the first goal he's ever scored against Manchester United, and what a time to do it. Manchester United knowing that Barclays League Championship is slipping more and more away from them, with Leeds having scored that victory at Bramall Lane this afternoon. Half-time then here at Anfield is Liverpool 1, Manchester United 0. This is the last time you'll see Anfield quite like this, as you can see on that picture there. The wonderful new Kemlin stand beginning to emerge on the other side of the ground there. And that will be fully opened at the start of the new season of the Premier League in August. Liverpool, we understand, is confusion. I think Liverpool are starting with 10 men, are they, in the second half?
2, 4, 6, 8, 10.
So we've got to work out, Saint, who's missing at the moment.
Dean Saunders is not there.
Feeling getting that back to Schmeichel. Oh, Dean Saunders is missing at the moment. Good spot.
Well, I said to you, Brian, early in the game, that when I also lost the two players, that that could be a telling factor in the game. I don't know what's happened to Dean Saunders, but it's going to be difficult playing with 10 men, isn't it?
It's with Kanchioskis. And a corner. Again, some very confusing messages, aren't we? He's got stitch and now he's gone for a stitch. So Saunders, at any rate, has got a slight problem and he's now back on the field. The problem has been solved. The stitch has been inserted.
Stitch at
and
time.
Saunders is back on the field. It's another corner for Manchester United. Liverpool leading by a goal to nil. Ian Rush, 11 minutes. Well, let's clarify. Dean Saunders has been having some treatment on his shin. Giggs with a corner for Manchester United. Floated in there. Mulby with a good header away. Helped on by Mark Walters. Phelan getting it in there once more. Bruce now for Manchester United. That's an obstruction by Houghton and a free kick. Taken by Dennis Irwin. McLaren and Hughes are furthest forward. Bruce is now. They're all going in there. Off the crossbar. Bruce and Kanchioskis. I'm not at all sure that he didn't crack the crossbar again and glance over. And so Manchester United so close to coming back to level terms in the opening minutes of this second half. Against the crossbar, and then as it comes out again, Kanchioskis, just as you see, flicks off the top of the bar again.
Well, that's worked three times this afternoon. I thought it was Brian McLaren that got the header in there. as you can see, it was McClure. And then Kaczelskis has a real whack at it and grazes the top of the bar.
Here's Saunders. He's onside. Great save by Schmeichel. Saunders again. Was that a handball? No, off the chest. Roger Gifford looked very hard at that one, Steve Bruce, but he said it came off Bruce's chest. But it was certainly a super save by Schmeichel. And if United are to retrieve anything from this game and from this season, that really was the most telling moment. Free kick.
Well, really, you've got to think the deep Saunders has had two great chances, and this big fella stopped them twice.
Bruce to Phelan. Clare trying to get Kaczelskis in, but look at the pace of Venison there, getting it back to Mike Hooper, his goalkeeper.
Donaghy versus Saunders.
Certainly Saunders sprang the offside trap so well there, and just couldn't find the finish to beat Schmeichel. Phelan with the throw. Robson available, no, a foul throw. Not from the right spot.
It's not often allowed to take it again then, is it? Usually to get it to the opposition.
Phelan again, knocking it back for Steve Bruce. Robson.
Well, here's the chance he had, and he really did well because he cut across Bruce there, cut across his path. Marvellous save, but I think this is where he let himself get down here. So he's got to play a good ball back. Now that looked like a handball, would you say?
Donaghy. Irwin again, up to Hughes, just onside, but the wind catching the ball, and it's a goal kick to Liverpool. United players back at the Chapman's home, enjoying no doubt this Liverpool victory as it is so far. They know that within a quarter of an hour, if it stays this way, Leeds United will be champions of the first division. Hughes to Irwin. Aldi. Bruce.
But increasingly you get the feeling now that Manchester United are just going to fall short of this quest for their first championship in 25 years. And you look back to only 8 goals scored in the last 10 games, and you look back to that defeat on Easter Monday at home to Nottingham Forest, defeat against West Ham in midweek. That's really where the crucial damage was done, but there's Giggs coming in right across the face of that goal. And it needed just a simple touch from 1, 2, 3, 4 Manchester United players. None could apply it. And Liverpool remain one goal ahead. But United get a corner. Giggs will take it. Played for Phelan. Here's Donaghy. Here's Irwin. It's a goal kick.
Well, I can't believe it, the way things are happening here. It's amazing, isn't it? Giggs, lovely little run again.
And look how many blue shirts are in.
All the blue shirts are there. It was right across. He split the 6-yard box. They're all piling in there. Oh, there's McClure coming in. Kaczelski's coming in. Everyone's in there. But the ball just won't run for them.
stopped by Irwin. Kept well in play there. Giggs. Here he goes again. That looked like a foul by Rob Jones then, I have to say. It's a throw to Liverpool. Giggs having a word with the referee, actually. Not that it'll do him any good. Went there, Liverpool waiting for Hooper to do something positive. Bennison, Saunders, Bennison, out of play, throw to Manchester United.
Super save by Peter Schmeichel, that time from Jan Molby. One Dane on another. Clearance there by Thomas. Donaghy. Kanchelskis. Inside, well inside the last 5 minutes, as Thomas makes one of those surges from the midfield. Shaking off even his own teammates there. Michael Thomas across the face of the goal. Houghton! It's in there by Walters. And now the title goes to Leeds United without any doubt at all. 2-0 to Liverpool. It's all up for Manchester United. The Leeds United players know that they can start congratulating each other. That the title goes to Ellen Road for the first time since 1974. Finishes the season. It finishes it for Manchester United. 2 goals down now. And there's no coming back from that. Rush 11 minutes. Walters with just 3 minutes left.
You've got to feel sorry for Brian Robson. And what was really his last year having a goal, winning a championship medal. And here you are. He's had a great season. There's nothing for him in the end.
Now for Manchester United. But unless there's an upheaval to end to beat all other upheavals, that's it finished, and this is just a formality as Barnes takes it up again. This is John Barnes, set upon making it three, but stopped once again by Peter Schmeichel, and Barnes down injured. Don't know how serious that is, but Schmeichel has gone to help him. That could be bad news. He's writhing in pain, as you can see, on the edge of that 6-yard area. Molby. And thinking about England and thinking about the European Championships, that might be quite a blow. Saunders on the far side for Liverpool. McClair taking on the world at the moment. Barnes back and hobbling badly. Saunders again. Bruce. Watson. The final whistle has gone. Leeds United are champions of the First Division of the Barclays League. Alex Ferguson, the disappointed manager of Manchester United, pointed to his team to say go and salute the
supporters. They have supported Manchester United manfully through this difficult season, particularly over the last difficult month. And Alec Ferguson, dignified to the last, adds his applause as well. A shattering disappointment for Brian Robson and all the Manchester United team and their fans. They've faltered over the last stride or two. Leeds United have certainly taken full advantage of that to win the championship for the first time since the days of Don Revie back in 1974. It all fell apart for Manchester United after their victory in the Rumbelows, where they were beaten by Nottingham Forest, beaten by West Ham, and now beaten here on this most crucial day by Liverpool.
So United missed out on the championship, but they didn't have to wait long for league success. They'd win it for the next two seasons. Hello and welcome to Sport Classics, and a chance to see some of the games and players that have made Liverpool and Manchester United such intense football rivals. We begin with cup tie football from the 70s. Main Road Manchester staged an epic FA Cup semi-final in 1979, watched by Brian Moore.
So referee David Richardson from Great Harwood gets the game underway. Manchester United in their white shirts and black shorts attacking the goal to our left. And I think the feeling is that Manchester United might well go hell for leather at Liverpool to try and shake them out of their beautiful stride early on in the game. Two sides in tremendous form. Manchester United lost only one of their last 11. Liverpool 16 without defeat and have conceded only two goals in their last 15 games. Kennedy's touch to Dalglish. Back to Kenny Dalglish again for Liverpool. And Koppel in to give Gary Bailey a first touch of the ball for Manchester United. And a long kick by him. And Hansen nodding it comfortably back for Ray Clements. Buchan versus Dalglish. Buchan misjudged it. Johnson was in behind there and succeeds in finding Ray Kennedy. Oh, what a ball here for McDermott. Played for Case. McDermott again, and he was shut down beautifully by McIlroy. And McIlroy, not content with that, was really hustling that ball out into touch. Case, though, with Liverpool's throw. Arthur Orbiston away. Hansen's header. A great competitive feel about a great cup tie here. And Thompson's boots too high on Jordan. And a free kick for Manchester United.
Shown great coolness in the opening minutes of this game. Two Liverpool players going for that. Dalglish and Souness getting in each other's way, and a free kick for Manchester United. Sammy McIlroy quickly finding Koppel. And Phil Thompson cutting it out well. Souness away, only to Orbiston. And in fact, some fun and games on the edge of the Liverpool penalty area, resulting in a free kick for Manchester United. As the sun comes out brightly here at Main Road. Now McIlroy is behind it. So too is Mickey Thomas. But it's McIlroy hitting it straight into the wall, and Phil Neal happy to thump it away. McIlroy, Thomas, Hansen, Buchan off balance, McDermott, and Johnson. And strong challenge there by McQueen, in fact hitting the ball against the Liverpool man, and McQueen applauding the referee and linesman's decision that gave the throw to Manchester United.
Johnson, or rather Jordan,
keeping the play for Neil. It's Thompson. And now Case. Flicked in there for Dalglish. Oh, Dalglish! And a goal! Dalglish! You can't give him a moment to think or a yard to work in a penalty area, and that's what United did there, but what skill! Bailey couldn't quite get to it, and just inside that far post. Liverpool a goal up, Kenny Dalglish, 17 minutes. Well, that's a sign of triumph from the little Scot. What a fantastic season. He's got 51 goals now in just over 100 appearances, striking at almost a goal every two games. And at this level, that is absolutely remarkable. And he's done it again today. Bailey went plunging after it, but once Dalglish had got past him, the whole thing was academic. Now, a task for Manchester United against a Liverpool side that's not conceded a goal in the Cup so far this season, and only two in the last 15 games. Greenoff, Jordan's right in there, and Jordan! Well, their reply was quick, and it was effective. That's when it all began, as Greenoff heaved it into the middle. Joe Jordan was there, just inside the post. Clements was beaten, and United are back. Ray Kennedy. Touched on by McDermott. And Johnson hoping to get in there. Case also hoping to get in there. And Alderson. The ball just wouldn't come down quickly enough for him to get it away. Neil now. McDermott. And now Alderson can nick it away here for Jimmy Greenoff. Wasn't a good ball played there by Greenoff. That's a nice one though for Case. And a good one coming in towards. Penalty! Is a controversial penalty. The shove in the back on Kenny Dalglish. Case playing it in there. Well, that seems a very, very, very harsh penalty indeed. McQueen has got a yellow card. But that seemed to me a guy with his hands at his side, making contact with the ball with his head. But the referee saw it another way. That seemed a desperately harsh penalty, but it gives Liverpool a chance, and it's Terry McDermott who's taking the penalty, and not Phil Neal. McDermott with the penalty, oh, he's missed it! Now, can Manchester United reform in time? Souness, oh, and a save! What drama! Great piece of play by Bailey, and Liverpool have lost two chances of going back into the lead. That's the penalty miss. Bailey going the wrong way. Here's the corner coming in, and it was McQueen who got the header. But I must say, my feeling is that justice was done. What an amazing series of incidents in that Manchester United penalty area. So poor old Terry McDermott having missed the penalty. And now a free kick for Manchester United. And Souness with that shot of his, brilliantly saved by Gary Bailey. So a free kick now for Manchester United. McElroy. McQueen right in there. So too was Chort. Neither got the touch. Massive throw. McDermott with the backward header. Thomas. And the referee wants a word with the Liverpool number two. And Orbison gets the free kick. Orbison again. Brian Greenoff. And Thomas there. Now can he turn it back? He can brilliantly. Hansen's header. Jimmy Greenoff. And Chalmers straight in the arms of Clements. And still United are carrying this great battle to Liverpool. Thomas turning it back well. Hansen's header. Jimmy Greenoff shot. And a lovely shot on the turn there by Jordan straight up Clements. Queen winning that again well. Oh. And it is. He turns around to find that the referee wants a word. Willfully grabbing at McQueen as McQueen is shaking his head. McQueen really was intent on going all his own way there. And Hansen suddenly realised it. And McQueen is up again, waiting for Buchan to take this free kick. It's Jordan's header and Thompson's clearance. Dalglish. And away go Liverpool now. Case. And Buchan's turn, no. Foul that time by Orbiston. And a free kick for Liverpool. Well, the referee's made a few decisions that the crowd don't like, but he can only give it as he sees it. And there goes the half-time whistle. Of course, the most controversial decision he gave was the penalty to Liverpool, which Terry McDermott missed, which gave Liverpool the chance of going into half-time with a 2-1 lead. As it is, it's 1-1, a really brilliant goal. Well, a good-headed goal by Joe Jordan, that so quickly followed that truly brilliant goal by Kenny Dalglish for Liverpool. Boos all around as the players go off, directed, I would think, in the main at the referee. The crowd haven't liked some of his decisions, but he can only give what he sees. And a half-time here in this FA Cup semi-final then stands at Manchester United 1, Liverpool 1, and we'll be back with the second half. Welcome back to Main Road then for the start of the second half of this FA Cup semi-final. Liverpool in the all-yellow strip, attacking the goal to our left. Manchester United in the black shorts. Buchan playing it back to Bailey. 1-1 it stands. Buchan. Cut out by Neil. Souness quickly switching it to McDermott. Case is outside him here. But here's Jimmy Greenoff. Nicol. It's a lovely ball for Jordan. A shot by Mickey Thomas off the mark. Flawed there. I think he made rather a meal of it, and fortunately for United, the ball went on to Thomas. Phil Thompson, Dalglish letting it round, Nicol tidying up. Thomas with the throw for United. No, he's going to leave it for Alderson. Jimmy Greenoff. Alderson chipping it in there. Brian Greenoff was right in there, playing much more forward in the second half. Topple's in there. And Brian Greenoff's in there. And Brian Greenoff has done it. This is the moment. Topple right in there. Greenoff, who played so far forward under the Liverpool crossbar, and Manchester United are in the lead. Back in again, and that's a Liverpool throw. Halfway through the second half now, and Manchester United leading by 2-1. Souness playing it short here for Phil Thompson. Chip in towards Ray Kennedy. And they tried to get the 1-2 going there, because as soon as Dalglish saw it was landing towards Kennedy, he was darting in there in front of the keeper. You watch that. See Dalglish go. But it fell for Bailey. Out of play, United throw. And Liverpool just cannot get the grip they want on this game at the moment, and they have now about 16 minutes to do it.
Come on, Everton, Liverpool!
And a free kick given to Manchester United. Or a foul on Jimmy Greenoff, right on the edge of the box, which perplexed Liverpool and delights Manchester United, particularly if they can make it pay. Now, Jimmy Greenoff's there. Mickey Thomas is around the place. Sammy McIlroy might well be having a dip here. It's McIlroy running over it, and Mickey Thomas. Oh, a marvellous save! Great goalkeeping, because the deflection was a wicked one there, off the wall. But Clements soaring beautifully to push it away. So 2-1 it remains, a quarter of an hour to go, and a quarter of an hour for Liverpool now to keep their dreams of a league and cup double alive. A quarter of an hour for Manchester United to hold on and take themselves back to Wembley again. McQueen is there, completely unmarked. Well, that's not only uncharacteristic of Liverpool, it's absolutely remarkable. Just look at the space in the six-yard area, too, for Gordon McQueen. No wonder Phil Thompson was furious with his defenders around him. Now McDermott. Now Greece is in there. And when he's around, all things are possible. Bailey had it and lost it, and will regret it if he's punished for this now, as McDermott turns it in. McQueen getting it away, only as far as Hughes. And Dalglish is in there! And it would have counted, there's no flag up. Getting in there, flicking it over Bailey, but also over the crossbar. Now
Rhys very nearly brought Liverpool right back into it there, having scored that brilliant opening goal of the afternoon. Well, there's a warning for Manchester United, depending on their fans are sort of the count chickens, and here's Popple! No! What a brilliant semi-final. One moment Liverpool were right back in it, you seem to think at any rate, and at the moment there, Popple could have made it safe for United.
Phil Thompson back to Ray Clements.
They've got to turn up the wick a little bit now, Liverpool, in the 12 minutes that remain, to prize this grip away from Manchester United. Mind you, their whole history at Liverpool is littered with amazing events in the last few minutes of games. And here's Kennedy finding Dalglish. That looked more a penalty to me than the one that was given. With Buchan with his arms all around the little stop. Thompson. And the Reds go marching in. The United fans are already beginning to celebrate, and that might just be a little too early. Although here's Jordan. And here's Jimmy Greenough. And Clements coming way out of his goal, and then Hughes backing him up. Good decision by linesman and referee. Greenough was maybe a foot inside his own half when that ball was played. Highway getting in behind. Touch back there for Kennedy. And will the excitement end? That was a great contribution from Highway. So neat there. Nicol caught a little bit unaware, in fact. Round he goes, and a good diving save by Bailey. And while you were on the slow motion there, a free kick given to Manchester United. What a fine piece of goalkeeping by this young man. Now it's with Brian Greenough. Phil Neal ducking in there. Souness getting it away, and a lot of space for McDermott to motor down that right. Here's Highway trying his luck on the right hand side now. Buchan following him faithfully. And a throw for Liverpool. 8 minutes to go. It'll find Dalglish. They dare not let him turn overhead there towards Johnson. Oh! Kicked off the line! And that's it, Buchan. From Graham Souness. And another corner. Up to his devilment again. There, Souness is shot, and Buchan on the line, getting it away with effort. And Liverpool's fans rousing them to make a really big effort in the 7 minutes that now remain. Neal finding McDermott, Highway outside him, Thompson up ahead of him. Bailey is down, and that's foul! Hanson! So near for United, and so far now, Thompson surging into the attack. Bailey can only touch it to Hanson. Thank you very much, the equaliser. 2-2. What an amazing cup tie, and what a brilliant one. Liverpool up. And then Manchester United level, and then off themselves, and now Liverpool are level. 7 minutes to go. And the noise is absolutely fantastic. Free kick. The first time, really, that Phil Thompson had ever gone up into an attacking position. And the smiles are back on Liverpool's face. First time that Thompson had gone forward, and it was his vital touch that opened up the way. And Hanson's first goal of the season. Maybe it yet could be United's turn. And look at the space out here now for Jimmy Greenough. cross coming in. Jordan coming to meet it. Ryan Greenough. Looks as though he's hardly got any strength left. Thomas putting it in. Hughes with the head of the flag. And now a break for Liverpool as Neil finds McDermott. And Johnson soaring up ahead of him. And Highway swarming down the left. Taking on Nicol. And a good save by Bailey. That would have just crept in. Highway looking in great form. And down goes Bailey, pushing it away. But another corner for Liverpool as we come to 89 minutes. One to go. Buckham got that header away. Souness playing it here for McDermott. A lot of yellow shirts are in there, but McQueen is back again for United. Now Hughes. And Dalglish. What space he was allowed, and he curled it. He saw Bailey a yard off his line and thought he might curl it in by the near post. And there's the strain of a manager, Dave Sexton, wondering now whether his side can hang on for these last few seconds. Dalglish over the head. McQueen with a header. What a game he's had. Neil trying to come in. Now Kennedy. And still the final whistle not coming. Hughes right in there. It's incredible this. And it's a free kick. It's a free kick for Liverpool. What an amazing game. And Souness finding Highway. Queen again there. That was a poor header by him, though. Popple. And the whistle's gone. And they've got it through it all again. My word, what a treat that's going to be on Wednesday night at Goodison Park. Kenny Dalglish, who scored an opening goal. And Alan Hansen, the other one for Liverpool. My word, what a tremendous game it was. With Joe Jordan and Brian Greenough scoring the Manchester United goals.
Well, Alan Hansen, you scored the vital equalising goal. What did it feel with so few minutes to go?
Well, I had that such a bad game that, you know, when it came over, I thought I was going to miss it. And the goalkeeper got a touch and it came up in the air and I just prodded it in. I scrambled more than anything. But, you know, we're pleased to get a draw. Although I feel we should have won the game, we're quite happy with the draw in the end.
United must have surprised you the way they fought right from the kickoff.
Yeah, well, we went a goal up and then I made a blunder for the first goal. And they came back into it well. But, you know, I think if Terry had scored with a penalty, they'd been struggling to come back again. But we showed a lot of fight near the end and we've got a replay.
How did you feel at half-time, especially Terry McDermott, having just missed that crucial penalty?
It was amazing, really. All the heads were down in the dressing room and, you know, we were drawn. It was as though we were getting beaten. But, you know, the boss and the coach just said a few words and the lads picked themselves up and it was great to come back to get a draw after being 2-1 down.
United would go on to win the replay 1-0 thanks to a goal from Jimmy Greenhoff, but they lose the final 3-2 to Arsenal. Coming next, the match from 1983 at Old Trafford. After a spell on the sidelines through injury, Ray Wilkins was back as captain of Manchester United for this league match against Liverpool at Old Trafford in 1983. And in the opposition for the first time in 16 games, again after recovering from injury, Phil Thompson. Martin Tyler is the commentator.
This is the 100th league meeting between Manchester United and Liverpool, fittingly with the clubs now as the Football League's two superpowers. And the bottom line today is that United must win to stop Liverpool disappearing over the horizon in the Championship marathon. Liverpool in their chain strip of all yellow and Ian Rush is caught offside. United's throw. movement coming from Whiteside. Free kick taken quickly by Muren. Souness reading the intentions of Duxbury, who can try again. Wilkins has got forward. This is Koppel. And Moses. Well, the deflections nearly unsettled Grobbelaar. It had to be a snapshot from Remy Moses. The ball came to him very quickly indeed. Koppel causing the problems first of all. And then Moses, it struck Liverpool players and the goalkeeper. And it ended as a corner. Half cleared by Neil, guarding the space at the near post. Dalglish. Good determination from Wilkins. In from Muren. The head of Lawrenson. And the hand of Johnston right on the edge of the area. Liverpool slightly protesting, but Ken Redfern was right on the spot. Johnston continuing the protest. And certainly possibilities here for Manchester United. A frantic 18 minutes played. Moran is involved in the wall for Manchester United. Here's Muren. And Liverpool are out quickly, maybe too quickly. And United will be given a second chance. Liverpool unhappy about the original award of the free kick, unhappy again about the referee allowing it to be retaken. And this time Manchester United look to bury the ploy. But Muren curls it, it needed the save. An acrobatic one it was from Grobbelaar. Was dropping in just under the bar. McQueen takes up his station. The in-swinger from Muren. And well played, Grobbelaar. Johnston. Kennedy can settle here. Whelan, I think, thought the pass was aimed for him. It was aimed, in fact, for Rush. And then Whelan is stopped by Duxbury. Duxbury diving in. Neil having to do the same against Orbiston. And Liverpool, for a second, had an extra man. Orbiston has now recovered. Here's Neil. And Steve Koppel was close to Phil Neil as he had the shot. At times, at Anfield particularly, Manchester United have used Koppel on Neil's side of the field to prevent the Liverpool right-back joining in attacks. Played by Duxbury in Koppel's direction. This is Whiteside. Koppel gets the cross in. Muren! Well, he almost hit it too cleanly. It may well be that there was an offside decision as well. But it embedded into the midriff of Grobbelaar from Muren's shot. Rush. Johnston with the header. Now Rush. And it might drop for Whelan. That fell just behind him. Duxbury's attempted forward pass fell straight for Kennedy. And then presented it to Alberston. Nicely laid off by Stapleton. Wilkins took just too long. And Johnston responding with energy. Has help here from Neil. And now Souness. Lee. For Dalglish. Wilkins, who was a good player who'd lost possession originally, won it back for United. And Thompson came in late to flatten Whiteside. And Ken Redfern wants a word with Phil Thompson. But before Manchester United can take the free kick, Kevin Moran requires more treatment. This time it's not the cut that's worrying him, it's the right knee. The readjustments passed on to Ray Wilkins. Kevin Moran is wheeled away. Lou Macari, who's been substitute for Manchester United 24 times this season. This is only the sixth time that he's come on, and the first time since November. And in the reorganisation, Duxbury lining up alongside McQueen. Whelan, and for the moment at least it seems that Lou Macari is playing at right back. And Dalglish, Liverpool almost adding insult to Manchester United to their injuries. Macari, certainly a defensive responsibility for him. Queen. Macari's pass, nicely judged for Moses and Stapleton. Moses again, Muren, the goal is open and Muren finds it. Manchester United turn misfortune to their advantage because Lou Macari, who goes across there to congratulate the scorer, started it all off with a perceptive pass from his right back position but found the run of Moses. It looked as though Stapleton had missed the chance, but Moses followed it up and then Muren took aim and fired it into the top of the net. First half remaining, and Lou Macari comes off the bench to good effect. United winning more of the 50-50 balls now. Ahead of Arthur Orbiston, the play has been stopped for offside, which is a tactic that Liverpool use well. Kennedy. Rush, Johnston, Dalglish, and Liverpool a level. Clinically done. United held the advantage for 4 minutes.
39 minutes and
Rush with the first touch, and what a good ball played by Craig Johnston for Dalglish to finish so decisively. So often about Liverpool that they're never more dangerous when the odds look to be stacked against them. McQueen. target. Coped with Orbiston's pass. Orbiston again. Now Whiteside. It was Orbiston who had been involved on two previous occasions in the move. Played across to the far post that stretched Liverpool. There's no one arriving for United. And here's Whiteside. Now Moses. Liverpool filled the gap with numbers. Well, Liverpool and Manchester United are locking horns here in a splendid battle. Arnold Muren giving Manchester United the lead 10 minutes before half-time after their fans had been disrupted again by injury, this time to Kevin Moran. And Kenny Dalglish, 4 minutes later, providing Liverpool's equaliser. At half-time at Old Trafford, it's Manchester United 1, Liverpool 1. Liverpool playing today under the scrutiny of a Polish camera. The tape of this game to be studied by Wiesław Lotz, Liverpool's opponents in the European Cup quarter-final in Poland next Wednesday. Ian Rush accidentally responsible for Kevin Moran's 9 stitches in a grotesquely gashed shin, but Moran in fact bringing about his own downfall by not wearing any shin pads. United attacking the Stretford end in the second half. Liverpool, the last team to win at Old Trafford. 1-0 in the first division here last April, on the night when Manchester United missed a penalty. Orbiston gets past Neil. Whiteside's gone to the near post. It might reach him. It did arrive a little behind Norman Whiteside, which prevented him getting any real power as he swung the left leg. Whiteside goes down. The free kick is given to Whiteside's satisfaction. And again, Ken Redfern wants Liverpool back the full distance. Noticeably Lee, who was attacking the ball. McQueen. Thompson did his job. McQueen complaining that he was balked as he made his run. I'm sure he was too. Muren. Manchester United have certainly got to take a gamble or two in their approach to the second half. And through pressure from Whiteside, they have another corner. This time poised to make a run from the edge of the area. In he goes. It was Thompson who cleared the day. Wilkins. Mercari. Grobbelaar enjoying the chance to show his sheer athleticism. He did have a good look, it seemed, at Mercari's volley and made a spectacular catch. And Bailey in trouble and out of his area. The hand wasn't used. Dalglish causing Bailey more problems by lying on the ground as Bailey tried to recapture his position. Bailey, his own momentum took him outside the area. The referee was right on the spot and felt that no arm was used. Well, this meeting has attracted the biggest league crowd of the season, 57,397. Souness. Is it away to Stapleton? Can Manchester United capitalise with Whiteside? Grobbelaar denies them. Whiteside feels that he had to dive in at the loose ball. Grobbelaar accepts that. Of all people, it was Graham Souness who presented the ball to Frank Stapleton. But look how Grobbelaar refused to commit himself here. Kept his shape, and Whiteside drilled the ball straight at him. Whelan is inside Kennedy. Wilkins, who gave the ball away initially, probably determined to try and win it back. Kennedy with the free kick. Johnston with a touch. Gives Lee some room in which to work. And Rush. He was jumping against Macari. And for all his gallant efforts, he's in unfamiliar territory. Ian Rush coming in beyond the far post. Headed just wide. Minutes remaining. Stapleton. The 1-2 with Coppell. Then Wilkins. They've left Muren. Well, the unlucky player was Norman Whiteside. Liverpool may well rue in this game the number of times that they left Arnold Muren unattended. He was able to volley the ball back into the middle here for Whiteside to flick at it. Whelan. He's pushed forward again beyond Dalglish. Souness. United supporters not appreciating this. Liverpool with Dalglish. And then Whelan. Just when it looked as though Liverpool were meandering through midfield, off darted Dalglish to take up a position that Souness found with great accuracy with the pass. And only Bailey's body stopped Liverpool taking the lead. Macari. Liverpool applying the pressure. Squeezing in on the man in possession and going forward themselves. And here's McQueen, who enjoys the forward sortie. Did the job for Liverpool. This is Johnston. Bailey touched it. Gary Johnston will remember well the goal that won the match here last April. He's looking to emulate that feat, stopped by Bailey's fingertips. Dalglish with the corner. Whelan and Johnston, the Liverpool players who are jumping. Neil. Johnston trying to turn Orbiston. And ran out of room. United asking Bailey to kick again. And that is painful on the right leg. Macari. On from Stapleton. Coppell chases. Two in the middle for United. Whiteside! That is a missed opportunity they will look back on. The this time, thanks to Stapleton's guided header, Koppel was able to get in across for good effect. Whiteside was in the right position but couldn't finish. Approaching the final minute. Whiteside drilling the pass for Orbiston. Muren. It's a corner. Much of football willing Manchester United to make this corner count to perhaps open up the title race. Taken by Muren, and it was Mukkari. Well, United can look back on the injury that saw them lose Kevin Moran and force them to a reorganisation. Here's Dalglish. For Rush. Moses came away with the ball. Into injury time. And McQueen. It was a despairing last attempt. But Liverpool thoroughly deserved their draw. And it's a draw that will satisfy them too. And only leaves Manchester United with a sense of missed opportunity. Particularly Norman Whiteside for the chance that came his way in the last phase of the game.
So, honours even at Old Trafford, Manchester United would go through the season unbeaten at home in the league, a terrific record. But they'd finish third, with Liverpool the champions. Hello and welcome to Sport Classics, and a chance to see some of the games and players that have made Liverpool and Manchester United such intense football rivals. By 1988, Liverpool had gone more than 6 years without recording a league win over Manchester United, home or away. Could they put the record straight at Anfield? Martin Tyler was watching.
In recent years, this has been more a confrontation than a contest. And Manchester United, not only 8 visits here without being beaten, 12 first division fixtures in all since they last lost to Liverpool. A big match with a big man in charge, Keith Hackett, who was the Football League's representative in the European Championships in the summer, and on Tuesday goes to Seoul to officiate in the Olympics. Sure to start at breathtaking pace. Here's Barry Venison for Liverpool. Manchester United in their change strip. White shirts, black shorts. Appearance by McGrath was rather a strange one across the face of the goal that he's defending. Not too far forward. Everywhere you look, internationals on view. Just one non-full international in each side. Here's John Barnes of England. And Steve Bruce, who hasn't actually been accorded the highest honour in the game yet. Clearing for Manchester United. Well, amongst forwards, Mark Hughes is a hard man. He's never one to be intimidated. And at times can be intimidating himself. The last fixture here between the two sides was simply extraordinary. It finished in a 3-3 draw last April when Liverpool led 3-1. Manchester United had Colin Gibson sent off then, but came back with 10 men to draw 3-3. Liverpool will feel that there's a score or two to settle here. Barnes, and it's too far ahead of Aldridge. It Gillespie, a little nudge cleverly by Hughes, and it dropped towards McClure. Hughes headed well, and it was all a little too quick, the rat-a-tat-tat of passes there between the three Manchester United men. Gillespie solidly above Hughes, played wide by Whelan. Here's Venison. Beardsley coming away from McGrath to make the pass possible, and now trying to get in beyond him. It bounced awkwardly for Bruce. It'll come for Barnes. And Leighton, who was beaten four times here on his only previous appearance almost 8 years ago when he came here in the European Cup with Aberdeen, really rescued Manchester United then. After Bruce had slipped, Beardsley was pressing on. It fell so invitingly for Barnes. But Jim Leighton, £750,000 of a goalkeeper, showed the wisdom of that investment in terms of the save. It was an inventive save in the way he thrust up his arms. Obstruction given against Olsen, who's now switched to the right. In comes Gillespie, and now Nicol! Well, a year ago, Steve Nicol couldn't stop scoring. He had 7 in 7 games at the start of last season, and he was operating mostly in midfield, but he hasn't got on target since then. But desperately close to breaking that run here. Well, it's no surprise, really, that there's been a casualty for Manchester United in this game already. A number of their players patched up to perform here. Alec Ferguson saying yesterday that he had 15 players of his professional staff on the treatment table, and Beardsley couldn't get the foot there quick enough after brilliance from Barnes. United really caved in as Barnes got into the area, a regular winner of penalties, and they couldn't risk the challenge at the last. But the pass, if anything, was just a shade too quick for Beardsley. That was Barnes, at times an enigma, at his best, bewildering the opposition. Anderson had to pull out in case he gave away the penalty. Aldridge pulling away. Help is at hand from Nicol. Help has made his way in on the far side, but that was brilliant from Barnes. Steve Nicol! The build-up there on the edge of the area was breathtaking. Nicol really the orchestrator, first of all in support of Aldridge, and then to capitalise almost on the back heel from Barnes.
tackle. Too strong for Olsen. Barnes. McGrath's header out. Collected though by Nigel Stackman. And when Barnes plays like this, he is a sight to behold, but no penalty. And all round Europe, they were wondering why he didn't turn on the style like that for England in the summer. Down he goes again, it's a penalty this time. So John Barnes, the outstanding individual in this first half, has earned Liverpool a penalty. 7 minutes remaining in the first half. Bruce flung himself into the tackle. You'll feel that he got the ball first. Not a view shared by Keith Hackett. Jim Leighton protested strongly. It's not Aldridge to take the penalty, it's Jan Mulby, and he scores from it. A testing kick, but a successful one. Kept low, Leighton went the right way, but Liverpool lead. Was again team play of the highest order from Liverpool, with Nichols forages down the left hand side, a great foil for Barnes, and all credit to Spackman. Not a match that it's easy to enter, particularly when you're unsure of your future with the club, and with the game well underway and the pace already set, Spackman has fitted in neatly. Liverpool's free kick. Manchester United have got a whistle in their favour when they were caught flat-footed. The free kick was given initially on the flagging of the linesman. Liverpool thought quickly. Bruce and company were disputing the decision. Hughes, Olsen, McClare, there haven't been many moments of menace from Manchester United in the first half, which has but a few seconds left to run, but that was one of them. Davenport. Anderson is there! Grobbelaar had to dive an awful long way, but there wasn't quite enough pace on the header to get past him. It was a most agile save, and it brings a rumbustious first half to a close. The talking point, the penalty, slotted in calmly by Jan Mulby after 38 minutes. One for Liverpool by John Barnes in difficult circumstances of magnificent skill in a game of helter-skelter pace. Manchester United will have their views on that decision, but that penalty is the difference between these two fierce rivals at the halfway stage. It's Liverpool 1, Manchester United 0. Well, guarding the Manchester United goal at the Kop end is Jim Leighton, who was booked for protesting when the penalty was awarded. So two yellow cards shown by Keith Hackett in the first half, the other for Liverpool's Jan Mulby. The second half is underway.
Something is happening in this place. Something you don't understand. Something you can't control. Something from somewhere else.
He wants to help me.
And now that something is happening to you. Friday Night Meals in the BT TV store.
We've got to get a squad back together.
We need the animal.
The CCTV picked up my client.
Meaning you have to find this rest.
Call of Duty World War II. Play map packs 30 days early. Only on PlayStation 4. For the players.
Football, 90 minutes where anything can happen. You can watch it and you can get involved in it with the latest Coral action.
New customers can get a massive 25-1 on a goal to be scored in the Real Madrid-Tottenham match at coral.co.uk/football.
Coral, jump in. Available from App Store and now Google Play when the fun stops, stop.
Discover dinners made easy at HelloFresh.co.uk and get your first box for half price.
When you're busy sawing here or fitting something there, when you're working here or here, with over 500 Screwfix stores nationwide, we're never far away. So, when you're cleaning up here or you need something when you're there, go online at screwfix.com today to find your nearest store. Screwfix, here when you need us.
Manchester United really have been a rare blot on Liverpool's marvellous First Division record in the 80s. There'll be no letting up from the home side here. But happily, despite those two bookings in the first half, no real legacy from the bad blood between the two camps from the match in April. Hughes given surprising room. Needs help, gets it from Brian Robson, who appeals for a corner and doesn't get it. So the man who's come from the maternity ward straight to the mayhem of the midfield of a match like this. Robson with plenty to celebrate whatever the result today, and there was a deflection, the replay showed. Barnes goes for the cross. United could have been forgiven for trying to consolidate their forces around Barnes. Hughes working hard, and McClare has got support from Robson and then went his own way. Again they appeal for a corner, again the referee says no, and suddenly Liverpool were caught out by Hughes' quick ball forward, Robson's run, which in the end McClare uses a decoy, it flicked off Steve Nicol. The ball just held up from Whelan's pass, didn't run on for Aldridge. Clever dummy by Hughes. And Hughes, who doesn't shirk a tackle, and the next one was late from Robson. Whelan lashed out. Other players got involved like Mulby, but Brian Robson let the atmosphere of this game get the better of him then. He had no chance of getting the ball. but no booking. That's why you're hearing the boos. The ball rolled loose. It was a fair challenge between Hughes and Spackman. And then, oh dear, that was a sliding lunge from the Manchester United and England captain. And you could almost excuse Whelan for his retaliation. Keith Hackett certainly took a sympathetic view of the incident. Barnes. And even his ball juggling couldn't prevent the Manchester United throw down. Anderson, who still has this heel problem that troubled him even during the summer when he was away with England. That's a clever pass from Duxbury. Blackmore for the run of McClure. Davenport loitering to the left and now ahead of McClure, but it's a big frame to pass out of Mulby. Aldridge one-on-one against McGrath, but not for long. Blackmore got back and McGrath was able to dispossess a distracted John Aldridge. Few matches pass as quickly as this one does. The speed is unrelenting. The technique is tremendous, and for the most part, the temperament, which is very important in this game, has been well controlled by the individuals out there. Nicol. The match started, remember, with 20 of the 22 players, full internationals. The non-internationals, Bruce and Venison, are now joined by Nigel Spackman. Bruce, of course, has played for the England B team. Gillespie able to show his composure even in this setting. Barnes, play on, good refereeing. Nicol is onside, Aldridge has gone to the near post. Checking out here is Peter Beardsley. Good positioning by the two Liverpool frontmen then to offer the two options. But Peter Beardsley not really a powerhouse in the air. Barnes a thorn in the side of Viv Anderson again. Ronnie Whelan. Aldridge. Here's Venison. Liverpool picking their passes. Houghton. United defended well. And Davenport leads the breakout. Blackmore quickly up in support. Duxbury wants help to his right. Anderson obliging. A lot of white shirts forward. Olsen. Well, it was just a little slow thinking then, and Beardsley improvised magnificently. Aldridge. Liverpool moving out so quickly that there's not too much help from midfield, but do they need it? John Aldridge determined to keep Ian Rush nailed down on that bench. Shoulder to shoulder. His goals are earning a stay of execution. That's the feeling on Merseyside for John Aldridge. but will it be a reprieve in the long term? Barnes. Well, they could charge 10 times the admission price for this match, and you wouldn't be short-changed. And here's Nigel Spackman! Great save by Leighton. Spackman robbed of his first goal for Liverpool. And Scotland's number one with a save of international quality. 20 minutes played in the second half. Mulvey. Nicol. This is marvellous. And Anderson had to take drastic measures. Just when you think the tempo must slacken, the game gets even quicker. We're still glorying in the Leighton save when Steve Nicol set off like an Olympic sprinter. And the notebook out by Keith Hackett this time. But Liverpool and Kenny Dalglish are never satisfied. Rush getting loose, but on the field all attention at the free kick. Will it be Mulvey? It's Barnes, and then it's late. Billy Garton is number 12 for Manchester United. A versatile defender. There have been more grimaces than grins. Beardsley. Oh, now what will the referee make of that? Barnes beseeches for a free kick. Anderson. Blocked off the run, shall we say. Stride for... Oh, no, he did more than that. He pulled Barnes back. And Spackman... not happy with McGrath. Benson. Beardsley to Houghton. Round the back is John Barnes. And now Spackman. It was a muddled sort of shot. It hit the post. Aldridge. It just won't go in for Spackman. Already denied by Leighton's save earlier in the half. A difficult ball to control, but he did keep it down. Beat Leighton this time. Couldn't beat the post. The applause is partly for the departure of John Aldridge, but mostly for the arrival of Ian Rush, who has added even more force to the magnetism of Liverpool on Merseyside. Rush screening the pass away to Beardsley. Past Bruce. Here's Spackman. And all Anderson can do, and he did it well, has put it behind and hell bent on scoring today, Nigel Spackman. Whelan. And that's a marvellous pass. For, Nicol and Farage off the line. Nicol after Bruce had robbed Russ. Nicol followed it in. But Rush, this would have been headlines in every Sunday paper, but for Bruce. Nicol skimmed the bar. Barnes. Two trying to stop him, but they can only do it by conceding the free kick, and that serves a double purpose for Liverpool. It gives them an opportunity to settle the destiny of the match with a second goal right at the last, but also uses up a few more seconds. And the latter, which seems to be the main priority, or is it? It's going to be another free kick. It's a match which has shown that you don't have to have goals to have entertainment of the highest order. A 1-0 win by a penalty. It looks as though it's going to go into the record books as. That will ignore the rich vein of captivating play. And control play too. And it is over. Listen to that reaction from the Liverpool supporters, because a sequence which has been a real irritation to Liverpool and their followers has come to an end. The one goal, Jan Molby's penalty, will be debated, I'm sure. But it stopped Manchester United's run at Anfield. A win over Manchester United in a league game for Liverpool for the first time here for almost 9 years. And remember, more than 6 years since Liverpool's previous league win over United, home or away. Publicly, Liverpool will probably say that this result doesn't mean anything more to them other than a win. The 3 points, after all, are the same. Privately, I'll tell you, their satisfaction will be immense. The scoreline that will give them that satisfaction, Liverpool 1, Manchester United 0.